So, you're looking for a drawing tablet. Maybe you're a beginner looking for something that you know is going to last and isn't going to break the bank. Well, maybe, just maybe, this 15-year-old Intuos 3 tablet is the option you should be looking at. Let's put it to the test, shall we? Hello, my name is Ryan. I'm an artist painting under the name Aiku, and welcome to my studio and the first drawing tablet review video that I'm doing for drawyourweapon.com. It's a website I started last year with the aim of sharing information and inspiration with young digital artists looking to make a start in their journey. You know, one of the questions I often see asked is, I'm on a budget, I need a cheap drawing tablet that's gonna last, you know, something that's not gonna have to be replaced in the next few months or even the next year or two. And often I'll see the likes of Huion or XP Pen recommended. These are more affordable alternatives to Wacom, and I use an XP Pen Deco Pro myself. But another option to consider are actually the older Wacom Intuos models that we're going to be looking at over the next couple of videos. In this one though, we're focusing on the Intuos 3. The tablet was released in 2006, and 15 years later, I still see people recommending it, still using it, and I'm quite excited to give it a test run today. Now, the first thing to point out about this is that it's a screenless pen tablet. It has to be plugged into a computer to work, and you can be looking at your computer screen while drawing on a different surface. This can take some time to get used to, but with a bit of practice, your hand-eye coordination clicks and it becomes like using a mouse. And that's all these tablets are. It's a fancy mouse. If you have a computer that can run digital painting software already, then this is also going to be your cheapest start to getting into digital painting and drawing. I was lucky enough to find this tablet going for about $40 on a secondhand marketplace, and I've seen other people have similar experiences as well. So it's best to keep your eyes open, check those marketplaces, and you might be able to find quite a bargain. I also found an Intuos 4 for about $45 in really good condition, so you could get lucky. Anyway, let's open up the box. Inside, you've got the tablet itself, of course. This is the Intuos 3 Medium, which is 8x6 inches. The smallest one they brought out in this range was 4x6 inches, and the largest being 19x12 inches. You get this 5-button mouse, which you're probably not going to use all that much, a battery-free grip pen with an eraser on the back, 2 buttons along the side, really comfortable to use. You get a pen holder and some spare nibs if you prefer a different feel for your pen, and there's a driver CD as well, but it's best to just download the latest driver straight from the Wacom website. The pen has got 1024 levels of pressure sensitivity. Now, if you compare that with a lot of the pens and tablets today that have about 8000 plus levels, this 1000 might seem like very little, but in practice, it's actually more than enough. You have a really good range, you can get light strokes, heavy strokes, everything in between, and the initial activation is really good as well. It's got tilt support, so depending on your brush settings, the brush is going to behave in different ways according to the angle of your pen. And on the tablet, you've got 4 express keys and a touch grip on either side. The 4x6 inch only has it on one side, but all the bigger models have it on both. So whether you're left-handed or right-handed, it's not going to matter. You're going to be able to take full advantage of those convenient express keys. These can also be customized in the driver settings, and you can set different presets for different programs as well. So if you use different shortcuts in your drawing software and your animation software, these will automatically switch over. You can also adjust the pressure curve, the active monitor if you're using multiple screens, all the usual stuff. So with that out of the way, let's get onto a drawing test and see what it's like to work with this thing. Okay, so I've got Krita 5 beta open over here. The beta was released a couple of weeks ago, and I've just been testing it out. A couple of new features. Anyway, when I open up a new file, generally I like to start with a gray background, sort of mid-tone to work on top of. Makes it a bit easier when it comes to putting lighting on my pieces. But that's not really a big deal for this. Just to explain briefly how I've got the tablet set up, I've got this allocated just to my one monitor, so these corners all line up with the corners of my main monitor and doesn't stretch over both. I've left the pressure settings standard, and I've just slightly customized the buttons. So the touch strip over here, I've just set to adjust the zoom. These two buttons are for just increasing and decreasing the size of my brush. Now, the difference here, as opposed to using my keyboard, is that I have to push the button down for each increment, whereas with the keyboard I can just push and hold to adjust the size of the brush, but no big deal. I've also got a sort of click to drag function here, because I often work on quite big canvases and zoomed in to put in some details, so that's quite useful to have. And then also good to have your Control Z, especially if you're doing or trying to do like long flowing confident lines. It helps to have that Control Z, because you'll likely have to do it a couple of times. And that's about it. So let's get on to a bit of a test here. Let's make the brush a bit smaller. I've got a brush selected that is set to change with the brush size. With the amount of pressure. So the more pressure I add, the more weight the line has. You can also have that with an opacity setting, so the lighter your strokes, the lighter the line, and as you apply more pressure, that's going to change. Let's go back to that size one, make the brush a bit smaller, do some quick lines. All looks pretty good, pretty smooth. I guess I could probably even do a bit of kind of cross-hatching sort of vibe. If I go really slowly, let's see what happens. Okay, there's a little bit of wave there, but that's mostly just because I have quite an unsteady hand. But I'll try with the ruler and see what that looks like. Oops. Yeah, nice and smooth. I quite like that. No issues with this. Got plenty of range. Remember, it is only 1024 levels of pressure sensitivity, but you can get all those sort of line weights from really thin and light to dark and heavy without any issue. If you prefer to push really lightly and still get quite a heavy stroke, then you can just adjust that in your tablet settings. So I'm going to move over now to Photoshop, and I'm going to do a bit of a sketch, see what it's like working in there. Okay. Okay, so what's the verdict? Do I think the Intuos 3 is a good drawing tablet for a beginner? I'm going to say absolutely yes, and if you can find one at a good price that's still in good condition, you're not going to be disappointed with this at all. It's got all the features you need. I don't see why it wouldn't be a good option for a beginner or even a more experienced user as well. Even if I had to pay probably double the price for this, I still think it would be quite a good purchase. And it's good knowing that a tablet like this is 15 years old and people are still using them. They're reliable. And actually, if you're using one, please let me know in the comments. Tell me what size tablet you're using. And now I'm going to carry on with that painting and get started with the next drawing tablet review. We're going to be looking at the Intuos 4. So if you found this video interesting, please hit that like button. I'd appreciate it. And if you want to know when those videos come out, then you know where the subscribe button is. And until then, happy drawing.